It's time for October's new fragrance haul. We do this every month. I talk to you guys about brand new releases. We've got Guerlain, we got the new from Paco Rabanne, the new from Maison Francis Kurkdjian, and tons of other new releases. So keep it right here. Let's get into these. Come on. Welcome back to another video. Max here with First Impressions haul video, the 1st of October 2022. I've got some special deals for you towards the end or maybe in the middle of the video, so stick around. Let's get into these. I got 8 brand new fragrances to share with you, starting with this one here from Bath & Body Works, which I haven't talked about in quite a while. There's one from this brand called White Musk that I love. And this one here is called Coffee and Whiskey. Now, as you know, I preface these bottles by taking out the wrap and getting a test strip here ready to go just to make things easier. And this one here is called Coffee and Whiskey, and I'm thinking that it's going to be a coffee and whiskey based scent. It's getting a ton of limelight. It is a cheapy type of a fragrance. Nothing too, I mean, the box is okay. The bottle looks quite nice. I mean, it's minimalist, but looks okay. You know, nice sticker there. So I don't know what to expect here, but this is getting quite a limelight on YouTube. People are talking about it, thinking it's a great scent for a very affordable price. I think it's about 35 or 40, between 35 and 40 bucks, give or take. Sometimes they have discounts. Nice sprayer too. This is nice, ladies and gentlemen. I am getting rather a very deep, musky, and sandalwood vibe here with a little bit of a tuberose nuance. I'm not quite getting much coffee and not quite getting much whiskey here, booziness from this fragrance. So it leans more feminine. I'll be quite honest with you. I'm not going to say, guys, go blind buy this. Do not do that. Try this first. It's not going to be for every guy out there. I think, obviously, predominantly, I talk about masculine or fragrances that are geared toward men, because I'm one. But of course, I talk about feminine fragrances. I talk about, you know, unisex fragrances. This one here, definitely unisex, but definitely leaning more on a female side of the scale. It is creamy. It is sweet. It's a little bit floral. I don't know how they got the same coffee and whiskey, because I'm not getting much of the coffee or the whiskey. So first impression here, 7 out of 10. It smells good for what it does, but it would have been much higher on if this was a coffee and whiskey kind of a fragrance, which it really is not. But from a first impression here, it smells good, but it's more of a tuberose, creamy, floral type of a scent. For ladies, this will be a great one. Now, this is a very intriguing one. It dropped last year. It's called A Drop by Dise from Issey Miyake, which you guys know I love. I haven't had the chance to open this, so I'm going to crack it open right now. So what got me curious about this fragrance were two things. The perfumer is actually a perfumer that I'm not familiar with. In Anio, I don't think I've followed her works, so that intrigued me for one. And number two, when you looked at the notes, it's talking about a milky note, ambroxan, some star anise, so some milky, you know, lactonic kind of notes, some spices, so quite intriguing. And the bottle itself looks quite nice and different. Reminds me of the Aqua collection from Bulgari, but again, this is from Issey Miyake. So looks like it's going to be more leaning toward feminine, but you never know. So let's take it for a test drive. Sprayer is actually built in the cap here. And this is nice. This is different. It gives me... You're not going to like this if you don't like this type of fragrance, but it gives me like an animalistic urinal cake kind of a vibe that you'd get with Yves Saint Laurent's Coros, but a lot less, you know, urinal, a lot less animalistic, but definitely here. This is floral. It's a little bit sharp. Not very lactonic. I thought from the milk note here, this would be more creamy and milkier, but it's not really. It's more of a green, sharp floral scent with the ambroxan. And again, that sharp animalistic undertone that I'm getting. It's okay. It's not my style. Definitely more feminine. Definitely more floral, sharp kind of a scent. I'm going to give this one a 6 3/4, 6.75. It smells okay, but it's not something that I would rock. But if you're a lady out there and you want something a little different, you know Issey Miyake delivers. I think this is going to be not only long-lasting, but it's quite unique as well. Come to think of it, guys, as I smell this before I get into the next one, I'm going to give this one a 6 out of 10. It's really not for me. But try it. You may love it. Next up, we have this one here from Dunhill, which you guys know Dunhill is one of those houses like Cartier, like Issey Miyake, under the radar, but always produces quality. And this one here from their collection, signature collection, which is like their private blend. The name had me at hello. I was like, I gotta try this just from the name alone. It's called Nordic Fougere. Nice presentation here. The bottles here are going to be very similar to the Icon collection, except for the bottom here is going to be all glass instead of metal, all metal like the Icon collection. The juice is blue, which I don't know what that means, but we're gonna find out now if it's gonna be more of a blue scent than a Fougere. Sprays are nice. So Nordic Fougere, it's going to be very clean, very soapy. There's a very creamy, musky, soapy kind of a vibe here. Definitely a little bit of an aquatic nuance along with that green lavender that I'm getting here. That's very soapy, very clean, very easy to wear. This is going to be a scent that I would say, you know, great for day wear, great for office wear, casual settings. Something that you don't want to think too much of, one of those fragrances that you want to wear daily, this is going to fit the bill. It's not nothing groundbreaking, outstanding, incredible here. It's just a nice, clean, easy to wear kind of a scent. Not getting much of a fougere, oak moss, you know, the darker fougere vibe here that you get with Dior's Elixir, you know, Sauvage Elixir. This is more of a clean blue kind of a scent. This is more on the cleaner side, like the Prada Loam kind of a style of fragrances. If you compare them side by side, obviously the Prada Loam is going to be more powdery. This is going to be greener and definitely stronger on the lavender, you know, soapy profile. This is nice. I'm giving this one a 7 out of 10. For what it does. Like I said, if you're looking for an easy to wear, blue, clean, soapy scent, this is good. So let's talk about Guerlain. This one here is called Epice Exquise, which would, I think, translate to exquisite spices, which I love spicy fragrances. This is their newest one from this particular collection that they have. And I was very intrigued by the name. The bottle is going to be this dark mocha brown kind of a color. And like I said, I was very intrigued about this one. The notes look great, so I can't wait to take this first test drive and share my thoughts with you guys. Thierry Vasser, the in-house perfumer, is the nose behind this fragrance. And the notes here look fire. We're talking coffee, cardamom, you know, various spices, patchouli. So it looks like it could be a great one for the seasons up ahead. Beastly sprayers. Okay, it's not quite what I expected or anticipated. It's more of a green spicy scent than a creamy coffee scent, which I thought it would be. There's angelica flower here as well, so I definitely get a lot of floral green and sharp, you know, nuances to this fragrance. I was expecting more of a gourmand, creamier coffee, like a macchiato mocha kind of a thing. Not the case here. It might develop and get warmer on skin because of the notes, but I think it's more of a green coffee than, like I said, more of a green than a gourmand style coffee that I favor. It is quality though. It is the Guerlain quality that you would expect. Just, I think that the bottle should have been dark green as opposed to the mocha color here, because it gives you more of a cacao, creamy, you know, gourmand nuance. And in fact, the scent is more of a green sharp scent. So I'm gonna give this one a 7 out of 10. Again, not my style. There is quality here. If you like green fragrances that are floral, a little bit of that green coffee vibe, I think there might be vetiver here as well. This could be a good one. I need to wear it on skin, live with it. I'm getting also a cumin note here that's, you know, not really great for a lot of people. I like it sometimes depending how it's blended, but again, I'm not favoring the combination of notes here. So 7 out of 10 for Epice Exquise. Definitely try before you buy it. So, and you could do that very well. And at any time, every time when I talk about new fragrances, new releases, top videos, you guys check out the partner of this channel, perfume.com. Your one stop for everything when it comes to trying, living with the scent. Great deals. Check out detail below. Crew pack, which you can get. Even the max packs, which you can get, mix and match for all the fragrances that I talked about throughout the seasons. You can mix and match, you get however many you want, and come up with your little discovery sets. And they are amazing. Thousands of fragrances to choose from, indie, designer, and niche. Use my code MAX12. And if there's any, you know, additional codes or discounts, I'm gonna link in the description of this video to make your life easier. But this is a one stop for all purposes when it comes to fragrance, trying, living with before you actually commit to a full bottle. Perfume.com, details below, guys. Check it out. Next one here from Paco Rabanne. We know they love to push the envelope, and this is the counterpart. This is the female version of Phantom, which was released last year, and this is called Fame. Now, little robot here. Let's open this up. Looks really cute. It's got a little sunglass. It is more of a feminine style robot. And what I loved about this fragrance when I, you know, first heard about it were the notes. I got really intrigued. We're talking about mango, frankincense, sandalwood. So I thought to myself, this could be something great for my wife to wear. And maybe I could steal some sprays. So it looks really cute. Nice little bottle. Again, they love to push the envelope. It's a little girl robot. So let's see. Sprayers are beastly. They always love to push the envelope over the last decades. 1 million. Ooh, this is nice, guys. This is sweet. It's sexy. Reminds me a little bit of La Vie Belle from Lancôme. But then the mango here is more of a green mango rather than a juicy and ripened kind of a mango, but it's definitely present. It's a little bit powdery, very floral, but sweet floral, not animalistic floral, not, you know, old school floral, more of a modern, you know, tuberose. Again, very predominant note in fragrances of now, in the last like 3 to 4 years. A lot of companies using tuberose, absolute, definitely here. a little bit of a solar vibe kind of a deal. It smells good. I'd love to smell this in my lady. I would not wear this because it's not my style. Again, it's more floral than anything, but it smells nice. It's very sensual, very sexy. I'm giving this one 7.5 out of 10 for a fruity floral fragrance with a little bit of an ambery touch and creaminess from the tuberose and the sandalwood. This is actually a very nice one. We're gonna do two Francis Carjan back to back. He is now the in-house perfumer for Dior, and he revived three old great fragrances from the Dior La Collection Privée, which we'll talk about one of them today. But before we do that, we're going to talk about his own house, Maison Francis Carjan 724. The newest release is the Eau de Parfum. So this is the bottle, guys. This is the big one, the 200 ml. And from what I read on the notes themselves, I think this is going to be rather a floral musky fragrance. Kind of like the lighter fragrances that we have from this line, you know, from the Aqua collection, those type of fragrances. Very white and clear juice. We're talking about jasmine, white florals, musk. So let's see what we get out of this. The sprays are always beastly. Quality here is never, you know, in doubt. You know, MFK is definitely one of the greats out there when it comes to niche. So the scent is really nice. In fact, I think my wife would love this more than I would. It's got aldehyde notes in here also, aldehylic notes. This reminds me a little bit of B612 from Nichané or Molecule One type scents. I don't think it's going to be a screamer. I think it's going to be closer to your skin, but give you a nice scent bubble and trail as you walk and move about. It's nice. It's really cool. It's a white floral slash musky and aldehylic kind of a fragrance. Again, not my style, but it does smell really good, and I would love to smell this in my wife. I think it's going to be one of her favorites. So for that, I'm giving this one a 7. It's a little bit soapy too. There's a nice cleanliness vibe to the scent. I'm giving this one here, guys, a 7.5 out of 10. So far, nothing here, you know, above 8. I think I've shared this with you a few times. If it's 6.5, 6.75, it's good, but it's not good enough for me to actually wear a lot of it. If it's 7 and up, 7.5, 7.75, it's really good. 8 is amazing, 9 is outstanding, and 10 is masterpiece. So I hardly ever give 10s here. So this one here is 7.5, quite good. I might steal some sprayers, but I think this is more inclined for my wife's taste than mine. But good stuff, nevertheless. So earlier this year, there was a lot of commotion, a lot of people talking about, as Francois Demarchi stepped out from Dior as their in-house perfumer, and Francis Carjan took that place. And he also talked about releasing a trilogy pack of fragrances from the original La Collection Privée, which included Eau Noir, Cologne Blanche, and Bois d'Argent, which I'm a fan of all three of them, but Eau Noir is definitely the one I wanted to try because it's that dark, you know, almost bacon, you know, powerful, smoky lavender fragrance that you get, very unique with a lot of cumin, so it's got a lot of that bio, animalistic vibe that a lot of people will stay away. So this is a re-release of that fragrance. It's not going to be as green as that particular fragrance was. I don't know if it's going to be powerful. I own the original Eau Noir cologne, which is, like I said, it's a showstopper, a room cleaning, it's gonna clear a room. It's one of those fragrances you walk in, if you put too much on, people are gonna walk away. If you love lavender, it's one of those fragrances. It's got anise in there, the licorice vibe, it's smoky. You have to try on skin though, because if you just try it on the blotter, you're not gonna love it. It's one of those things that has to develop. It's a very complex scent. So this is the new one. It's a yellowish juice. It's not the green like we had with the original, which I'll pop it on screen here. So let's see what this one is all about. Dior, one of the best sprayers in the game, just like Chanel. Okay, so very similar to that smell of the original. You got the anise here, you got the green lavender, the smoky facets, the cumin. Quite similar to that beastly fragrance. I think it's still gonna be beastly in performance, but definitely toned down on the cumin, on the smoky facet. It's not as dark, not as beastly and cumin, you know, predominant as that particular one, but it is quite anise. That dry black licorice is definitely present here. I sense some patchouli as well in the base. It's a nice scent. I love the original, so of course I'm gonna like this one. I don't know how it's gonna perform on skin, but on scent alone, I gotta give this one an 8 out of 10. I think it's a great fragrance. It's one of the greats out there. If you like unique fragrances, definitely check this one out. Cologne Blanche is going to be more of a clean, everyday type of a scent. Bois d'Argent is a phenomenal iris fragrance, creamy, buttery. But this one here, for those that like unique, definitely check it out. And last but not least, I'm going to talk about a second iteration of this fragrance, which was the original one. The OG was released last year. Both 100 ml, the one I talked about and review for you guys, is the H24 Hermes Eau de Toilette, which I'll pop the card here so you can check that review. And if you remember, I wasn't a big fan of that fragrance. I think I gave it like a 7 out of 10. It was good. You know, it was more of a floral, clean, almost aldehydic type of a fragrance. It got a ton of limelight in the fragrance industry. Again, not my favorite style of fragrances, but this one here, on the other hand, I can't wait to try it. This is the H24 Parfum Edition. The 100 ml will cost $137, which I think is $30 more than the EDT. Darker juice. I am very excited to try this one, guys. I was really hopeful because I didn't like the EDT. So let's see what we get out of this one. Okay, so from the get-go, you're gonna get that powdery citrus kind of introduction that you get with the original. But this is definitely richer, it's definitely denser, more deep of a scent. What I love about this one is I looked in the notes, and it's definitely present here. Instead of the clary sage, they actually added oak moss, which is one of my favorite notes in perfumery. So it's going to be greener, it's gonna have more of an old school, old world goodness type of a vibe that I favor in fragrances. So this one here, at Hello, to me is an 8 out of 10. It goes up a point from the original EDT, for sure. If you were not a fan of the original H24, I urge you to try this one. I think you're gonna love it. If you have a taste similar to mine, if you like old school fougères, this one here is keeping the citrus opening, but there's definitely deeper, darker, that lavender oak moss feel that you're gonna get in the heart, and as the fragrance develops on the skin, I can tell it's definitely gonna come through. One of my favorites here from this haul, guys, H24 Parfum. Definitely an improvement from the original. So most of these are actually new releases, 2021/2022, you know, later last year, earlier this year, up until now. So if you wanna check these fragrances and ton of new releases, check out fragrancebuy.ca, the partner of this channel. They always get the latest and the greatest for the best affordable price. Most importantly, all authentic, fast shipping, and outstanding customer service like no other. My one-stop all things fragrance for years now. I've been talking about them for 5+ years here on the channel. They are the partners. I always like to partner with people that brings quality, of course, service, and authenticity. It's important to me, and it's important to you guys. So check them out, details below. Of course, all the fragrances are linked below to make your life easier. That's what we do here on the channel. Don't forget to check out ScentExplore.com. Register today, guys. It's going fast. The International Perfume Niche Convention, guys, New York City, December 2nd and 3rd. I truly hope to see you there in person. All details, program schedules, check the site. Don't miss out. As always, guys, choose your fragrances wisely and wear what truly moves you. I'll see you right back here very soon.